commercial water today.
Water's down, sun is shining. That little bit of viz?
It's on. It's time to get some gold. We're gonna get to the bottom of this thing today. Hey.
After 3 months dredging McKinley Creek, the Dakota Boys are about to hit bedrock and a gold deposit worth millions.
I'm gonna put that dip hole in there, see what we got going. Hopefully it's good.
Dustin must recoup his $75,000 investment before anyone gets paid.
Dude.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
That's a good 12 feet right there anyway.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
Music to my ears right now.
God.
It's a race to the gold.
Last season, they hit bedrock gold at 4.5 meters.
Look at that.
Now they have just under a meter to go.
We've got a limited amount of time. Right now, we're really close. If everything goes right today, I think we'll be all the way across bedrock cleaned.
Yeah.
We are back down the hard pack. We have no more excuses. This is it. It's if we blow it, it's our fault. Let's do this.
75-year-old Fred Hurt, the crew's most experienced diver, will be leading the mission.
Yeah.
Now Fred's keeping the team alive today. The old guy is kicking ass.
We're gonna attack that hard pack this morning with the chipper. We can make some headway into that stuff.
I'm going for the bottom. I want to be the first one to find that gold.
All that lies between the crew and the gold on bedrock is a layer of compacted gravel known as hard pack. The air chipper, a pneumatic chisel, is the only tool they have that can get them through to the gold.
All right, buddy, you ready to rock and roll?
Ready, let's do it.
Yep, we're good. Have a good dive, find that gold.
Gotta go get the gold. Yee-hoo!
Get some, buddy.
Joining Fred today is former Marine Sergeant and commercial diver, Carlos Minor.
Just gonna try to do my job, brother. You know what I mean? Dig, 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 man, to bedrock.
Carlos!
On my way! On my way! On my way!
Yeah, it's a good day! It's a good day, man!
Game on!
All right, Fred, I'm gonna come and join you. Dive for one in the water.
Thank you.
Oh, that's good for water.
All right, I think I see some of that hard pack right here. All right, you'll have the chipper ready.
Good, just about me on bottom.
I have the gun. All right, you ready?
Yep.
I want to see what's at the bottom of that damn hole.
Get some, Fred. Get some.
This is good. We're back on track. Decent weather, clear water. Ready to kick some ass.
Oh, well, it's going down. What would it take? A lot of effort. Got it. Real hard track here. Damn bit is stumped. God damn it.
Got to be kidding me.
I can't pull it up. Maybe y'all can lower a rope down there and it's
like
pull it.
Tell me that we want to put a rope on it and then we can't pull it out.
It break just because he keeps on ramming.
Chip and hammer all rigged up. Come up on the wind.
Come up on the wind.
Man, that is not coming out. Oh, there it goes. There it goes. Also.
Then pull the bit out of the rock.
Then pulled it in half. That spring.
Yep, that spring's no good. We're done with that tool for today.
We're so close to being there, and we can't get through that hard pack. Damn, that's frustrating.
Uh-oh. I know you're going to blame me for pulling too hard.
Fred won't listen to directions. He won't do what we want him to. He just wants to show that he can still do stuff. I'm starting to give up on life here. Fred is making this so hard for me. I don't see any way for me to succeed if he keeps messing around like this.
So here's the bottom line. Fred broke it. Fred went straight down. Didn't chip his way. A little bit at a time, he just buried it until it stuck.
You can't see what you're doing, and sometimes you bury it into the hard pack and you try to pull it out, it breaks that spring. I'm not sure we can continue with that.
Without the air chipper, the crew will not be able to get through the hard pack to the gold before winter ends their season.